Hi, I'm Ignatius Sokori, the founder of Get Opaque Electrical. Welcome to our channel. Hi, I'm Engineer James Okori, and in this video I want us to see how contactors work. So I will be using these contactors to demonstrate to you how these contactors work. We'll be using this contactor, we'll be seeing the terminals and how they work. So looking at the contactors, you'll see that every contactor must have this terminal of the coil. This is the terminal of the coil, A1 and A2 of this contactor coil, A1 and A2 of this contactor. And when you look at this, you see A1 and A2. When you look at this as well, you see A1 and A2. When you look at this contactor as well, you see A1 and A2, meaning that every contactor have A1 and A2 terminal, which means that it has coil. Okay, this contactor have coil inside, and inside the coil, the coil terminals are these A1 and A2 terminals of this contactor. So I will go ahead and open this contactor for us to see how inside is. So I'll go ahead and open this contactor, losing it this side and losing this one this side. Okay, so when you open the contactor, this is how the inside of the contactor is. Alright, now this contactor, now when you look at it, see that every contactor must have a coil. This is the coil of this contactor, and this is the terminal I showed you about. This is the terminal number A1 and A2 of this contactor, which is the coil terminal of this contactor. And when you look at it, you see that it has these two ions, and this is a spring. So how does this contactor work? Alright, so contactors obey the principle of electromagnetism, which means that when you supply current to the coil of this contactor, there will be a magnetic force that will be formed around the coil of this contactor, meaning that immediately you supply current, there will be a magnetic force here, and the work of a magnet is to attract any metal that is closer to it. Looking at it, you see that this metal is closer to this coil, so it will magnetize this metal, meaning that it will magnetize it like this, which means that it will switch it automatically, and the work of this spring is to enable it go back to the origin, that is go back immediately there is no supply to the coil. Alright, so every contactor has a switch. When you look at it, you see that all these things are switches. All these things are switches of these contactors. Okay, now this switch now is attached to this spring, and the coil of this contactor, just like this, will be like this. Okay, so and the spring will be like this. So immediately you supply current to the coil of this contactor, there will be a magnetic force formed around the coil, which will attract this metal to this, enabling it to switch automatically on its own without human intervention or without anybody pressing it. Okay, so this is how contactors work. We'll go ahead and connect this contactor, that is to supply current to the A1 and A2 of this contactor, to see how it works automatically and to see how it's been connected. So looking at this contactor now, you see that this is LU1 and LU2, and this LU3, and this is 13. This is T1. Sorry, this is T1, this is T2, this is T3, and this is 14. Now L1 and L2, L1 and T1 are normally open, L2 and T2 are normally open, L3 and T3 are normally open, 13 and 14 are normally open. What I mean by normally open is that when you supply current to these input terminals, there won't be any output here until you press it, thereby closing these two together. That is closing these two and these two together. Now looking at it very well again, you see that this is the A1 and the A2 terminals. Now we first of all go ahead and connect these to see how when we connect the input to L1 and L2, that is the supply, to see if we can get output to T1 and T2. Now looking at this, now you see that I've connected the supply to terminal number L1 and L2 of this contactor, and I connected the load, I use this as load, to terminal number T1 and T2 of the contactor. Alright, so I will go ahead and plug this, that is socket it. When you socket it, you see that there is nothing like output here until you press it, meaning that this is a switch that I'm using to press it manually, but I want this to work automatically. So what do? I have to supply the current to terminal A1 and A2 of this contactor. So let's go ahead and supply current to it. Alright, so I will connect this the live wire to the A1 of this contactor, which is this. Okay, and I will connect this neutral wire to this A2 terminal of this contactor, which is this place. Okay, so and I will test. So immediately you supply current to this. Okay, immediately you supply current to this, you see that it will automatically switch on its own
without you using your hand to on and off it. So this is how contactors work automatically, and this is how you connect contactors, okay? So this is how you connect contactors to work automatically. You can as well decide to put any button, that is, you can decide to put any switch or anyhow in any panel or in anywhere you see contactor. This is the only way contactor works, no matter how big or small a contactor is. All right, so I explained this using these components, and this is the internal part of contactor. This is the only way the internal part of contactor is, okay? And these are contactors I use for this experiment. All right, thank you very much for watching. I still remember my humble self, Engineer James Okori, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Just click on the subscribe button, it's free, and you'll be seeing all our videos anytime we post them. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you.
All right, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos.